He shouldn't be twerking.
He shouldn't be. He shouldn't exist. I wish that he was dead.
This is the kind of one-off game where, like, I was like, oh, I can't fucking take anymore. And then I look at my watch and we've been playing for 1 minute and 30 seconds.
Oh, boy.
Please, no more! Why do you have that gun?
It freezes mice.
It freezes mice. That's the only thing it does. Yeah. It doesn't do anything else.
Who cares about the cats? Who cares about the bats? Who cares? Yeah, the cats don't even care.
No.
The fucking,
what?
Bouncing future football?
future football?
In the future, they decided that football wasn't the right thing to do.
Dennis! You in there playing with my butt ball! So help me God!
So help me God, I'll slap you in the face so hard!
You're getting 7 across the ass! Don't ask! I had 3 of my fingers on my right hand blown off in Korea!
You're gonna wish your mother wasn't scared of me!
Oh my God.
I could smack you across the room and nobody would be any the wiser! You're always playing out in those fields!
Mrs. the Menace! Dennis came over to my house and fell down the stairs again! Again! He's so clumsy!
You should probably put him in ballet! That would embarrass, I mean, make him better at balancing!
Jesus Christ. What are you doing in my mystical house of living teacups?
What are you doing jumping next to my coins, which you cannot grab?
Yeah, the most enticing reward you can have in this entire house. Can't touch it. Just more butt balls.
Just because my future self transported himself back in time and gave me the future's most popular sport doesn't mean you can just break in and play it!
Dennis, I'm sorry I yelled at you just there. What we're gonna do now is I'm gonna learn you how to play butt ball. Seeing as you're in my basement.
Oh my God.
Step 1, never tell your parents.
By the way... Step 2, never tell your parents!
Just a reminder to everybody, football is a great way to work those glutes. Until then, hello everybody and welcome to The Brony Show, episode 395. I am your host, as always, here to bring you the fun and silliness of the Brony community for yet another week. I am your host, Circuit Main, enjoying a wonderful Memorial Day holiday, which ate up my time with lawn mowing, watching YouTube, taking baths, and cooking up eggs and potatoes. But we'll get to that in a moment. Let's go ahead and introduce our wonderful cavalcade of panelists. Both familiar faces and some slightly newer ones, because they haven't been around too much. We, of course, are joined early by Crazy Matt Capitan.
Lies, I'm lurking.
We also have Short Circuit, who is definitely lurking at the moment. We are also joined by Tech Stallion, who may or may not be lurking as well. It appears to be lurking. And we are also joined by Toakoi.
I never lurk. I'm very loud. I can step in real life. You will not see me coming.
And we are...
I forgot I was muted.
Okay, there's Textalion.
I can get that installer to download it all.
Ugh.
Well, the one for the Sea Pony Quest.
Did you use the, we'll get into that in a moment anyway.
And we also have joining us Suki of the Otaku Ascended.
Yeah, I'm here. Let's go.
All right, well, we're going to go ahead and jump right into the big thing here for anybody watching live. Now, over the weekend, we had not one, but two conventions going almost back-to-back because the Ponies Online had their convention, and then they kind of took a breather on their schedule to allow CPonyCon to have theirs as well. That was done completely through Minecraft. Of course, Ponies Online also had a few panels during that time, and then they closed out, and then shortly afterwards, Quantum Sea PonyCon closed out. So, yeah, they kind of ran in tandem, and the fun thing about Sea PonyCon is it was completely done in Minecraft, which is really amazing stuff, and we were lucky. We kind of got a little bit lucky. I was able to jump in with Creature, CMC, and Toa to check out the server before the events began, and then things kind of went up in flames shortly afterwards. Just to put it down quickly here, so when the event began, they had the server set for 255 people, I believe, and they...
is what I saw before.
Yeah.
Went local.
And then, yeah, when they started... it got swarmed. People wanted in so badly that it kept breaking the server. So they ended up having to restrict the number of people to 55. And it kept at the max of 55 the entire time.
Wow.
Yeah.
And Ponies Online and CPonyCon did have streams so you could watch the panels.
Oh, yeah, they had streams up so people could actually watch the panels and everything, so you wouldn't miss out if you didn't have Minecraft or you couldn't get in. Now, the fun thing is that CPonyCon did say that they're going to keep their server up, called the Medium, until for a while at least, so that people could still check it out. They're going to keep the vendor hall as it is so people can check that out and everything else, and... It was really amazing, and our hopes were that everything would be up and going and we'd be able to jump in on the show today and check things out. Unfortunately, it looks like there are still some slight server issues and they are still working on it, to the point where we tried to get the installer, which did not quite work, so I had to put my installer in a Dropbox for Suki and Tech to try to download and install, which it sounds like they had moderate success in that regard.
It got installed, but once I got to the actual, once I got to actually looking up the server, it said can't connect to it.
Yes, so unfortunately the server does look like it is completely down at the moment, which they did put up a warning, it may be down for a day or two. The only other issue is that the server, they actually did show, when you actually go to the Connect, it says that it's up and running on the website itself, so I kind of got mixed messages and just wanted to check 100% for myself.
I hope they at least make the map available for people to be able to see later.
I hope so.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
Yeah, multiple people are having that problem. It's on their Discord.
Yeah.
Well,
at the moment, we cannot do CPonyCon this week. We may try again next week once things are a little more settled. However, we still had Minecraft on the brain, and I still wanted to try running it down. So, Short Circuit, actually, is Short Circuit here now, or?
He might have stepped away, but yesterday, while Suki and you were playing, I got onto the server and built a wall.
Okay, so Short Circuit is here.
So my headphones mute themselves, so I didn't hit the mute button.
All right then. I guess we'll hear it straight from the horse's mouth. So
yeah,
sure.
Go
ahead.
So I have a server that I have that we're gonna use right now.
Well,
try to find the best way to get people in to it, but yeah, no, we got a server, we've got a section set up for the Brony show that we might actually be able to keep as long as people behave, we might actually be able to keep as a regular server section.
So, yep, the Brony show may have an official part of a server, which, I'm okay with that. Now, of course, I was trying to get... I do have a pony mod installed for Minecraft. I was trying to get it to work. However, Trying to install a previous version of a pony mod is a lot more difficult than you would think. And unfortunately, when they tried to upgrade the server yesterday, that went horribly wrong.
Yeah, well, so we had to, well, we had to downgrade the server because the guys who regularly play on their server can't run the newest version of Minecraft till Optifine comes out because it'll kill their computer.
Uh-huh. Yep. So at the moment we are playing on an older version, which is
1.14.4.
My bad. My bad. But yeah, and
1.44 was years ago.
Okay. my bad on that.
The latest version of Minecraft currently is, I think, 1.15.2.
That is the most current version, and
yeah, 1.15 is current. 1.16 is the stuff in the snapshots.
Yeah. Yeah, that is the most current, and that is the one that is the version I actually got the pony mod to work, just to actually show it off here a little bit. Wow, this thing prepares all the time, doesn't it?
Remind me at some point. I'll have to try to cook you up a anthro version of your skin.
Oh, I already did a human version of it, so I can send that to you.
Short Circuit.
We've got that section on Short Circuit server where we can actually teach Circuit Minecraft things.
Yeah, I know
I've not
very
done
little.
Anything yet.
Well, I know very and little, I'm... and we are probably going to explore the server a little bit. It is safe, right? We're not going to have anything that we're going to have to start putting black bars around or anything like that.
Oh, yeah, no, nothing, there shouldn't be anything like that. That was the previous server we had where the naked Luna was, statue was.
Is that part
which
I don't...
Which I blame on the other guys because I made a statue. I made a pixel image of Luna in this white robe, and somebody came onto the server, looked at it, and said, "Why don't you get clothes on?" I said, "Mother, give me 5 minutes."
Beautiful.
I couldn't tell if he was kidding or not. But yeah, here's the Minecraft 15.2 single player, and you can see I actually got the mod up, so I'm playing as Twilight because it's fun.
2.4 gigahertz.
So yeah, unfortunately, I couldn't figure out how to get it working in time for this because of we had to make a lot of quick last second changes. So either case, so we'll be Minecrafting with Bronies. So.
One of the techs just responded. He claimed that the server is down, but he's going to upload a mirror for it right now.
Oh, how long do you think that'll take?
Not sure.
Yeah. Well,
here,
keep an eye
I'll
on that.
I'll give you the invite to the... are you in the Project C PonyCon Discord?
I am in that, yeah.
Yeah, go to the tech support and you'll see his message.
All right. Well, I also kind of got a bounce between the show and here, so could you just keep an eye on that and let me know if they actually manage to get that going before we get jumped in on this, but... For the moment, we're still planning on shorts unless somehow they manage to make a mirror at ridiculously fast pace. I can't imagine it go really quickly, though, but I don't know. I could be wrong.
And, I'm waiting.
Well, in any case, so let's go ahead and go into the news here. We do have some bits of news. Of course, we're going to go ahead and let people toot their own horns, and somebody here does deserve a little bit of tooting. So we're going to start off with a little bit of What's Up, Brony. So, what's up, Toa?
I spent 3 hours animating my robot character in GIMP via layers talking about robotic ponies. And I got at least 21 people in there. And I was happy. That is all.
So yeah, you did a 3-hour panel?
Yep.
Well, I tried animating.
I
was going to say is you're not doing animation now. Oh, do I have a connection? It is connect. Wait, what?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to be hearing about this.
My internet says no network access, and yet I just access.
Alright, well. I gotta admit, I'm impressed, but I'm also kind of mortified that you literally spent 3 hours doing this.
It's no different than us doing the Depibaru stuff.
We don't spend 3 hours. Wow. Yeah. Sorry, I just don't know a lot. I don't know a lot of panels that go 3 hours. Ever. So, I am impressed, but that had to have been exhausting at some point.
During the end, I was like, ooh. And every time I did a time call out, it was like, oh, that's all I'm going to be going, and I still have this month? All right, so John.
Huh.
Okay, come on, you stupid.
Well, in any case, credit to Toa at least for putting in so much effort, and you know, I admit not many people would throw down a 3-hour panel. That takes something.
And it was mostly by myself, occasionally interacting with chat, but yeah.
Well, I guess you have your when you have your passions. So we're gonna go ahead and move on here. And does anybody have any other what's up, bronies? I agree with DM21. That takes a lot of dedication. And Ponyman 64 did see some of it. Glass 4, that was the panel Toakoi did for Ponies Online. Obsession could also be considered part of it, yeah. Technically, passion and obsession are separated by a very thin line at times.
Like I say, I will say, if you're trying to animate something and it's not like a normal convention where you have somebody trying to kick you out of the room, honestly, yeah. 3 hours sounds quick. Like it should be more like 6 to 9 hours.
True. Yeah, if you don't have people saying, okay, your time is almost up, but there's some people that you basically have to stop them or else they'll keep going.
But, besides, think for doing something while doing animation, think more like a Let's Play rather than just our stuff here. Think how long Let's Plays go.
Yeah.
And Glass 4 almost hit a cow.
Medication.
Ugh. Ooh. All right, any case, That's it from Toa. Like I said, as for me, I don't really have much of a what's up Bernie going on. Just same stuff as usual. In fact, I do have to apologize a little bit. Unfortunately, I didn't get a chance to do the art challenge this week. A lot of stuff. There was some stuff going on. Plus, with the holiday, I kind of took it easy, a little too easy, and I didn't have a chance to sit down and do the work. So, the art challenge, I don't have anything for the art challenge, but I don't think a lot of people did anything for the art challenge because Memorial Day is a holiday.
Yep.
So, we're
only in the U.S.
So, I thought about it, and we are going to get to that in a little bit. I am going to throw something a little bit different in regards to the art challenge, especially since beginning next week will be the artist training ground from Equestria Daily. That will actually begin the first day of the next show. So we start the same time they start. So again, we'll get to that in a little bit. But let's go. Does anybody have any other what's up, Brony? The silence is golden. We shall move forward. So, as mentioned, Quantum Sea Pony Con and Ponies Online were the latest MLP online conventions. The next one is PonyFest 3.0, marking off the third day of technically a 3-day convention that was split up into several different weeks. Split up by a few weeks. If you haven't had a chance to check out an online convention yet, this might actually be close to your last chance because after this, they kind of stop, almost. So PonyFest Online will have their convention, and then the second live convention will happen. However, that is a month long, so that one's going to be kind of interesting, and I am relearning how to do things in Second Life so I can try to report on it, because that is what I do. I do actually check these things out for everybody but I'm still working on trying to second life it. And Brony Bash does have a convention on June 19th and 20th. And there is going to be another Burning Mare that will be either next month or the month after that. But as for actual panel conventions, that Ponyfest, Second Life, and Brony Bash are the last ones. However, the same time that Ponyfest Online is happening, another convention called the LuniCon will be happening during the entire weekend, beginning on Friday and ending on Sunday. So it will be the 29th to the 31st, right in the middle of, well, right around Ponyfest Online. And the reason we bring up LuniCon is because, A, I know the creator and person behind it, and B, it's a different convention as it deals with all Western animation, not just ponies. So it could be worth checking out if you are curious about other Western animation shows, or you're a fan of other things, such as the World of Gumball, Gravity Falls, Garfield. There's also Garfield. There's also the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, or you got the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Oh, hey, Tsuki, what was that other show that they had in 2006?
Wait, what now?
The other cartoon show, the one that, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles? Yeah, that was it.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Fuck.
I'm making fun of the fact that basically we got four different versions of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles at this point.
Actually, there's more like 6 or 10.
No, it's just, it's I think it's 4. I really think it's 4. Actually, I'm not going to dive too much into that. I think that would scare me.
Don't go into the set of hole. Yeah. Do not do it.
But yeah, it should be worth checking out, so remember to check out LuniCon. It hasn't been, it's not part of the pony conventions because it's an animation convention altogether, but it is founded by Looney, who is a big brony, goes to a lot of the brony conventions as well, and, you know, he's a nice guy, so it is definitely worth a check out.
I have danced with the turtle in the pale moonlight, and I had...
That's a scary thought, and we're going to move on as quickly as possible. So, the last clip show has finally been aired. Friendship is Forever, Memories and More, which dealt with Starlight and Spike, which, okay, I'll give them a little bit of credit that they squeezed Starlight and Spike together in one of them instead of keeping them. I honestly thought that we would get one clip show with just Twilight Sparkle itself, but then again, all of the other clip shows kind of dealt with the main six and Twilight. Well, the main six with Twilight, so yeah, fair enough, I guess.
Well, then again, both of them later go on to important roles within Equestrian society, so I really don't see why not.
I don't see any, yeah. But yeah, if the last little bit of new MLP animation that we got, outside of the stop motions, is now out. So savor it like you would that last little morsel of steak that you got over at that steakhouse from 3 years ago, and you kept it in your freezer, and you kept that little morsel there just for that one moment where you know you can reheat it just before it gets freezer burned and get a little bit of taste because you know that the steakhouse burnt down last year. And if it didn't, it probably would have been shut down anyway because the owner kind of kept doing weird things in the back with his hands and not sanitizing, and it's probably best not to think about it.
Circuit, you just said you wanted somebody to die. Just, I'm sorry. Freezing things keep things good for longer. Not 3 years longer.
True. Fair enough. I was trying to go on a tangent here.
It'll put hair on your chest.
It'll put hair somewhere, that's for sure.
I make random assumptions.
It'll put hair on the back of your tongue after you eat that.
it'll put hair on your chest. Mind you, that hair might be from the decay of your dead body, but still there.
Still, it's worth checking out, though. Now, with that pony, We are starting to see a slow emergence of pony life over at different Hasbro feeds. I'm just going to start with this. Over in the Instagram, the Pony Life Expressions got posted. And honestly, I'm kind of digging them a little bit just because they're so over the top.
Now to do the scary part for me.
I mean, I could easily see these as just like over the top smileys for Twitch or a Discord server.
Honestly, the best out of these, I go with B and H, maybe A and F if we're going.
Honestly, I go with E and G, but I just like the idea of spastic. E looks like somebody is shoving things around where they honestly shouldn't. I'm just going to leave that up to imagination. And G looks like Pinky got into the wrong white powder.
By the way, short, sorry. I sent you a message over the... I sent you a direct message, but can you give me the details on the server? I had to re-download Minecraft, so I don't have that server information anymore.
Okay, it's changed before. It's changed since then, but it should be simple. Just give me a second here to...
All right. G looks coked out of her mind. G in upset. Yeah, I think everybody can pretty much get down with G. That was just the most perfect facing there. But yeah, this
no.
I admit it still has me major concern with because this is the this is what we're seeing. But I don't know how the characters are actually going to come out. I mean, they are over the top expressions. That doesn't necessarily mean that the stories are going to be decent. However, the other thing that they have also put up in their Instagram is the Rarity inner and outward self. Which I'm sure some people out there would probably dig the idea of Rarity with a messy mane.
Which, what I like here is, I think Equestria Daily screwed this up. I'm pretty sure those are supposed to be the other way around.
Oh, no, I'm definitely sure they're supposed to be the other way around.
Or is this like a... Oh, yeah. See, yeah, it's supposed to be the other way around, because it's like, yeah.
I think you skipped over a couple of things, Circuit.
Oh, no, I did. I just wanted to jump in on this as quickly as possible.
Oh, okay.
Because, I don't know, it was... These images were messing with me. It kind of has me in a weird kind of flux state. I'm still concerned about what the hell they're bringing, but at least at the same time, I don't feel like that this is going... that it feels like a train wreck going down a cliff.
No, it just feels like...
But it is a train teetering on the edge of a cliff as it's spinning around the mountaintop, and it's just... You can kind of feel it lurching a little bit, and you're trying really hard to lean to the right while it's kind of leaning to the left, and praying like somehow your shift in body weight is enough to prevent it from launching off of the side.
No, Circuit, it is a Indian train going across a mountain with people standing on top of it, and you ask, how is this even possible?
Commander, some Earth to Circuit, come in Circuit. Sorry, I'm gone, man. I'm completely gone, or is nobody hearing me?
I can hear you.
Yeah.
Okay, no, I think Commander something is missed.
Well...
Commander something. I think he had a little too much of the G. Too much of the G. Maybe I had a little too much G. Yeah, let's go ahead and move on. So, yeah, Pony Life is slowly trickling in. We're getting a little bit more and a little bit more at a time. We just don't know what will come. So let's go ahead and move on to news that we can talk about a little bit more. HarmonyCon has unfortunately lost their venue for next year. And not in the way you would expect. The Crown Plaza Addison, where HarmonyCon and also Nightmare Night Dallas has occurred every year. Unfortunately, it looks like coronavirus has officially ended the tradition by shutting down the entire hotel. Permanently. So, yeah, that's surprising. But, yeah, right now they're looking for a new home base. They're not giving up on HarmonyCon at all, but it is kind of sad and surprising that an entire hotel got shut down because of coronavirus. Especially one that a that bronies frequent. Did anybody actually go to Harmony Con or Nightmare Nights, Dallas?
I went to Nightmare Nights for a couple of years.
Mm.
Yeah, Winchester was there, I believe, AB.
Yeah, I think Winchester was there because I think it goes to Harmony Con as well. Was it Harmony Con and Ponyville Cider Fest or? In any case, at the moment, yeah, they're looking for another venue, so we'll see what happens with that. How was that venue anyway? While you were there for Nightmare Nights.
It was 2016 and 2017.
Good venue?
How was the venue?
Yeah, how was it?
Pretty good, although the hotel is kind of pricey to stay at.
Yeah, maybe for the best and to move. Well, we'll see what happens. We'll keep our fingers crossed for him. Well, let's go into CMC rant mode. Kids Day for the My Little Pony game event went live a few days ago. And at the moment, most of what 90% of what CMC is about to go off of, I fully support because I'm kind of with agreement with him on a lot of this. With that,
this event is about the young six, the main six being turned into young fillies. You see this? They're all available to buy. They are the event helpers. They are not the rewards. To buy them each individually is $14 each. To buy them as a whole pack, it's $60.
I mean, you save $30.
Yeah, but that is...
The thing to ploy on the whales. And as well as once you get past the third point, the reward for the third point of this event is, oh yes, here is this big 50% off on gem purchases for a while.
Yeah, they get a
this
coupon.
This is an event aimed toward milking the whales before they stop playing this game.
Which sucks.
Oh no, it is 110% terrible. However, there is one thing that I do have to give it credit for because it did launch an art meme that I am 110% with.
Oh, yes. It's a beautiful outfit that Trixie has in the first bit there. It's such a snuggly little sweater.
Yep. Snug little sweater and pigtails.
I've seen one with a young starlight being drawn.
But yeah, people have seen this outfit and they are taking off with it.
Yeah. Oh my God. Oh Jesus. Of course, these fuckers gave a bunch of artists that came out of the anime fandom a twin tail pony. Fuck you.
Well, technically, we already have a twin tail pony if you look at the model of Applejack.
Ooh, he's right.
Applejack's a whole nother mess. Oh, there, we're gonna leave that one alone. But yeah, so it has one good thing, but it's unfortunately really milky. So yeah,
it's something that I'm gonna go as far as I can in this first run, but I'm hoping to get the end of it all in the rerun.
Yeah.
The only one that I've bought with my backstash is Rainbow Dash, because that's gonna help me with the second half of the event here.
So
I should poke it.
Now, who wants to go? Who wants to get students?
Oh, right.
Well, too bad you're getting students.
That you can, the rewards you do get for this are Pony Ocellus and Pony Yona.
Oh, well, there's irony.
That's not bad. Also, but, why is San Juan not there? God damn it.
I don't know. But the student six are finally in more merchandise. In this case, it's the Squishy Mashems.
Why?
That's not the why I'm wondering. What I'm wondering is why they have Cozy Glow. Why do they have Cozy Glow and not Sandbar?
Beats me.
Why do they have Cozy Glow and not Sandbar?
Why don't they have Best Pwn?
I have no idea. It makes absolutely no sense. But he's
great.
Well, let's see the last.
He's a great Pwn, but according to the server, Twist is Best Pwn.
Well,
he's such an aloof doof. He is best.
I'm down with that, CMC. But here's the thing, though. Ocelus got shafted the other time that was doing things, so I think they choose someone to shaft every time to have Cozy.
They can obviously make a set of seven.
Either that or stop promoting Cozy Glow because she's supposed to be a villain. And she's not very nice. Okay. She kind of sucks. Those curls are weird. Why Mashems? Mashems does everybody. Mashems are the trickle down from the blind bags.
Okay, I'm gonna TP you out of here, Suki. For some reason, the game's been kind of. We can't let the villagers out as we escape this.
Yeah.
You can TP him to.
Yeah, because that's where it spawned me.
Yeah, no. So the spawns. It's an old server, and the spawns kind of frigged up. I don't know why.
Oh, I remember this server now. I don't think that was there.
All right. Well, no, while they're getting that figured out, next step, Vinyl and Octavia Day is coming out on Equestria Daily in 2 days. Though technically, this is actually rapidly turning into Musician Pwny Day.
Ooh, no Songbird, Color Turret, and Sapphire Shores. Yeah. I'm interested to see what art comes out of this.
Oh, I'm excited to see it too. The art, the videos, the music. I'm pretty sure though that we're gonna get that silly SFM one where you got a Coloratura doing faces past sending homebound, and then just at the end they just kind of got the crazy face and just mashing the keyboard.
Oh,
because that's funny.
Yeah, this is. Yeah, no, we're not unpeaceful. I've got to see. Give me a second. I gotta remember how to set the day time.
All right. Anyway, moving right along on the next little bit of news that we have. Let's go on to game news, because why not? First off, somebody is making a Doki Doki Literature Club Pwny mod. Okay. We don't know why.
Is it just replacing them all of the things with ponies, or is it actually making whole new dialogue chains, whole new characters.
A new mod in the progress that swaps the game over to cartoon horses with new pathways, new story, and more.
A new game.
So, and it's just barely getting started, though, so there isn't any trailers, demos, or anything outside of a couple of screen caps.
Yeah. I mean, people have been... Actually, some of the mod community on DDLC has actually been pretty cool. People have been, you know, pretty much going through and really just having a lot of fun and, like, really expanding the universe in there.
Yeah, which is...
I've seen a couple of stories. Like, there's one where it's actually, like, the entire month after, but you're with, who's the one that does cupcakes?
I honestly don't know. I only remember some of the weird, freaky imagery and the fact that one of them basically traps you forever.
Give me a second.
The fun part is the one that does actually edit game files so that that it's... who is it? Just Monica?
Monica.
Just Monica.
You know what? There's a solution while we're doing this, Suki.
Alright, any case, while they keep working on that now... that's coming out, but that's not the only thing coming out. We also have... A new MLP mobile... a mobile game.
There's redstone everywhere.
We have a mobile puzzler with an actual pony character as the main character.
Oh, what? Interesting.
Yep, it's called Nora Galaxio. It's basically a brick breaker, but the main character that pops up here and there is actually a pony character.
Interesting.
That's
So I spawned down there.
I'm not sure if my current phone can handle what's going on there.
I'm not sure either, but mine's been giving me issues left and right, so I don't know. It might be time for an update.
I need to replace the battery as well as I really need to replace this phone.
Yeah.
Like I say, when the server was first set up, you used to spawn right here, but like now it seems to be just spawny-wanny everywhere, but you're set to creative anyway, so nothing's going to kill you this time.
All right. And, okay, yeah, well, they're still trying to hammer that out. One last thing that we have in the news. Drawing 101 with Sarah Richard, who draws a lot of the MLP comics. Emerald City Comic Con had an online convention, or at least an online event happen a few days ago. And Sarah Richard was one of the special announcements that they had, where she does a one-on-one how to draw panel, and she kind of helps you learn to draw with ponies. Yeah, you can see right here, skipping a little bit ahead, you can see her art style as well as her instructions and things like that. So, yeah, if you wanted to get an idea of how to draw ponies from one of the comic artists, you have an opportunity now. Which is great, because in about a week, we have the we have the artist training ground coming up. Sorry, I kind of got absorbed into watching the Derpy getting drawn there. So, with that is
Derpy,
going to...
Don't be sorry.
I won't be then. But, in regards to that, it is now time for the challenge of the week. And
yeah,
somewhat.
Usually I'm going to call with him and tell him to join.
Okay. But the challenge of the week was fruits. With the protest... With the protest challenge of what?
Hugs.
Hugs, yeah. So...
Fruits that hugs? Scandalous.
Yep. And we do got two entries here. Originally, I thought it was just going to be Toa, but we also got one Vaguely Creepy here. Now, what I'm going to be doing for the entries before we start talking about these is I am keeping these up for another week, as I mentioned... We have this. Today's a holiday, and next week after that will be the start of the artist training ground. And I don't want to push people into starting to try to keep up with these as well as doing artist training ground. So, in any case, we are keeping the current challenge of fruits. I don't know if Coldust will keep the current protest challenge of hugs.
He hasn't sent me anything, so I think we're just going to roll it right in.
All right, but we'll go ahead and we'll keep that challenge for next week, as well as put in one additional one, which will be a simple, good warm-up challenge. But first, let's go ahead and go to our entries. Now, of course, we have mentioned Toakoi, who has a challenge of a baby bat pony with a bunch of grapes, and I can only... it's a thumb.
It's a photo.
Well, I'm talking about the big thing that almost looked like you were trying to cover it with a PSP. So, yeah, we have basically a photo. And grapes, and a pony. Simple enough. And we also have Vaguely Creepy, who wrote up a story. It's going to be a little bit longer than usual, so I'm going to go ahead and get started reading this. If I don't accidentally click on the wrong thing.
Right. Apparently, Commander sent something.
Commander? Oh, yeah, Commander also had... I apologize.
Oh, right, that cute thing.
Commander also did draw this while we were doing the show last week. Oh, I can't believe I forgot.
Oh, this is an old art of his.
Yeah, but he still sent it in.
Yeah, he sent it in last week.
And the whole idea is, the challenge of the week is not just to create the art, it's also to look around for it, or maybe submit something that you've done before. Granted, you know, creativity will always get a big thumbs up, but you know, even an old art challenge, just seeing Applejack hugging a giant apple is always heartwarming.
Twice as long as averaged vaguely, what did you do?
Well, let's find out. So, Vaguely Creepy has written Bear Hugs, the next chapter of the saga of the Brony Show. I mean, I probably wouldn't have thought about it at all, but the more he kept telling us about it, the weirder it started getting. I know, right? Even if it isn't like that anymore, what if the train car bounced or something? Circuit agreed as he and Suki stepped out of the restroom and back into the main part of the station. Looking around for his other friends, his gaze paused on a fruit basket nearby with a sign hanging over it that read, "Compliments of the Station." After a moment, he pointed it out to Suki, and speaking of weird, why put that there? Suki glanced over. That is weird. I'm not eating anything left that close to a public bathroom. He agreed before starting to search for the others again. Now, where are Cole and CMC? Before the two could head off in any one direction, a booming voice called out to them, "Hey, it's you guys!" In unison, the two turned around and their jaws fell slack at the sight of the approaching stallion. He had a dull purple coat and a big, friendly grin, but more than anything, he was huge. He had muscles aplenty, but he himself was just generally massive, practically a full-sized horse compared to the two ponies. Hi, sorry, do we know you? Suki asked warily. The stallion let out another laugh. Ha! Pretending you don't recognize me. Classic. Bring it in, fellas. Big hug. No, wait, seriously, who are... Suki tried to protest once more before being swept up into a bone-crushing hug with Circuit. The big stallion just laughed. Ha! Such a kidder, he barked, hugging him tighter. It's me, he said, his grin stretching wider still. Your friend, he said, suddenly deathly quiet as he kept squeezing harder. Is this a friend of yours? Hearing CMC's voice, the stallion looked up to see him and Coldust standing a short distance away, both their hammers at the ready. Oh yeah, we're good friends, the hulking stallion said through gritted teeth, nodding maniacally while Sirkin and Suki shook their heads no just as fast. Seeing the panic on their friends' faces, CMC strode forward and raised his hammer. Yeah, I don't think so. Drop them. He yelled as he swung it down, only to feel a shock through his entire body when the head of his mallet rebounded off the hulking horse like it had hit a brick wall. Help! Circuit called. We're trying! CMC shouted as he started raining blow after blow from his hammer, all bouncing harmlessly off the assailant's oversized muscles. Having no better luck with his own weapon, Cole yelled out in frustration. First the filly or mare or whatever the hell she was with the plants. Now this guy, who are you idiots? Hearing this, Suki's eyes widened as much as they could when they were already being bugged out of his head from the big guy's iron death grip. Someone else like this guy, with plants, he raised a hoof and shakily pointed across the room. Fruit! Get fruit! Sparing a second glance around, Cole spotted the basket. Fruit? They never had that here before, he said to himself before realization struck in. Oh! In a flash, he bounded over to the basket, grabbed an apple out of it, and spun on his hoof, throwing it as hard as he could. Suki, catch! Suki stuck out his foreleg and swiped at the apple, nearly fumbling it before he managed to grasp it. With what little strength he had left, he reached up and jammed it into the mouth of the laughing behemoth. The stallion resisted briefly before realizing it was only a piece of fruit, at which point he quickly chewed it up and swallowed it, thrilled to let them see their last-ditch effort fail. For several long, terror-riddled moments, he just glared at them with the same manic smile, juices running down his chin. Suddenly, a look of shock crossed his face, and he dropped Circuit and Suki to grab at his throat. Still wheezing for breath, Circuit climbed up to his hooves, trying to be ready to keep fighting. Yeah, what the hell was that? Poisoned? I don't know, but a weird fruit basket shows up for the first time ever in a station right after we get attacked with plants? It's something dangerous, Cole replied, watching their attacker with his hammer at the ready. As if to answer his uncertainty, the huge pony started heaving and choking like he was about to vomit. Instead of bile, though, thin branches pushed out of his mouth, a slender sapling seemingly growing from his throat before beginning to transform into a full-grown tree. A beat passed, and the four friends stared, shouting in confusion and fear. Holy crap, shouldn't we help him? He literally just tried to crush us. They yelled to each other in a fresh panic for several long seconds more. Before they could debate the point further, a strangled cry of rage snapped their collective attention back to the stallion. With a look of intense concentration and anger, he unleashed one more mighty yell, threw his head forward, and forced his mouth shut, crushing the sprouting trunk in his jaws in a shower of splinters and spit. He had fallen to his knees, gasping for breath, but he was successful biting through each new twig and branch, hacking up entire chunks of wood faster than the tree could grow. With lurching, stumbling motions, he started to crawl towards the four friends, new sprouts worming their way through his teeth as he began to regain his footing. "Or we could run?" Circuit asked nervously. "I'm okay with running," Suki replied quickly. "Running sounds good," Cole added just as fast. "Let's run," agreed CMC. So they ran, only pausing to smash the rest of the fruit in the basket before leaving the juggernaut of a pony in their dust while he was still recovering.
Now, did a flock of seagulls start playing a song while you ran?
No. Just, no.
This sounds like a friendly station.
I know, right? They give you fresh fruit, and they want to grow more trees. How could you not love the station like that? So I'm gonna give the awards here. We got Commander Something with the Something Old But Good Award. We have Tolokoi with the Photograph. Every time we look at this, it makes us laugh. Award. And we have Vaguely Creepy with the Hulk and the Tree Award, I guess.
I would go with Continuity Award.
He's been doing the Continuity Award for several right stories now. He's got the Continuity Banner.
I'm going with the Moving Towards a Fetish Award.
Yes. You know what? I shouldn't ask.
In my Sunday D&D campaign, we keep joking about one character getting fetish after every interaction we have.
I do agree with DM21. That story definitely had a bit more of a bite to it. pun not intended. But with that, the challenge for next week is simple. Draw a pony. However, there's a stipulation to this. I would like people to draw, or not even draw, or write. Maybe write a poem about a pony. Maybe do a music song based on a pony. Maybe do a movie about a pony. Maybe take a picture of a pony figure. But the whole idea is to do whatever creativity you want off of a pony you have never done with before.
So you can't use any pony that you've previously used.
So if you keep drawing your OC, no. If you write a story about all of the Applejack all the time, no Applejack. If you do a song based off
the song, into the background ponies list.
The background ponies, maybe another OC that people may have heard of, maybe even somebody completely different. Create your own special OC just for that story. But the whole idea is something that you have not done before. Because I want something simple. I want to give you something simple, but I also want you to stretch beyond the boundaries. Drawing the same thing, making the same music, doing the same stories over and over does not stretch. It never stretches you. You have to push those boundaries in order to get to see improvement.
So, I'm gonna say here, because the theme that Circuit's going for, it's not quite the same as the protest challenge. But I'm gonna throw out something for you guys, because this is something also that you gotta get into too. Maybe draw the pony in a way you haven't done. So if you do pony all the time, try an anthro or a humanized pony.
You could do that as well. You haven't done before. Yeah, you could do it in a way you have not done before as well.
Okay, so I'm adding to the header, try something new. Because trying to get all of this stuff is going to be annoying to try and fit into the header.
Yeah, no, just go for the try something new, but like...
Well, I'd say pony, try something new. I think that should get the general idea across. Pony, but try something new. But yeah, I like that little addition. Thank you, Short. And Now, let's... We do have the Protoss Initiative Challenge here, or do we have one?
I thought we were rolling back Fruit and Hugs again.
We are still rolling... We are still doing Fruit and Hugs. I just wanted to know if if Coldust wanted to add on like I just did as well.
Cole has not sent a message since I tried to poke about the protest, so I don't have anything specific.
Your world.
Go with some weird action. I don't know. Brain just dropped everything there. Short, give me a verb.
Actually, Short, maybe you can come up with a protest since we're going to be abusing your Minecraft server here in just a moment.
Okay. So the current challenge is draw a pony you haven't drawn before, draw something new.
Yeah.
Draw a pony you have drawn before in an old-timey style. So think like ancient Disney or something like that if you can.
Okay. So just to expand on it, just expand on it since we want to this encompass everything, not just art, but also music, video, you know, just...
Right. I'm just going to write these down as pony, try something new, and pony, try something old.
Yeah, or try something classic.
You know what, right? Yeah, write it down like that. Pony, try something old / classic. And then see what people come up with from there, because anything will work at that point. It's kind of fun when you give them enough to play with.
It's fun if you give them enough. I'm just worried about also giving them a little bit of choice paralysis. You give them so much to choose that they can't decide.
It's easy to just always go for something sepia toned.
Follow me.
Glad of Draconiquist. Something old, something new, something borrowed, something blue. draw the wedding of fruit ponies.
Sorry, we already did.
Hey, there he is.
Noteworthy, so we already had blue. Sorry.